now we'll move ahead. We have to start from line 389. I must eat my dinner. So Caliban says that I must finish my dinner before I go out and listen to Prospero and his daughter. So I need to first finish my food which I am eating. This island's mine by Sycorax, my mother. So this is what he tells Prospero, that I am eating my dinner and I need to finish it first. So Caliban says that this island's mine. Now this is the grudge which Caliban had against Prospero. Why is Caliban annoyed with Prospero? This paragraph gives the reason for this. This island's mine. He believes that this island belongs to him by Sycorax, my mother, which thou takest from me. So this is his greatest problem, that he feels that this island belonged to him. Why? Because his mother was the ruler of this island. This island belonged to his mother. And so after the death of his mother, this island will automatically belong to Caliban. But what happened? Prospero came to this island and he took away that island, took away the control of that island from Caliban to Caliban. And now Prospero became the ruler of this island and started controlling everything which was happening on that island. When thou camest first, now this is another thing. When thou camest first, thou strokest me and madest much of me. Wouldest give me water with berries in it and teach me how to name the bigger light and how the less. So these are the things which Caliban tells, that when thou camest first means when you first came to this island, then what did you do? You strokest me. Strokest means me, it means you fondled me. You treated me in a proper manner. You were good to me. So you cared for me, you fondled me, and madest me much of me, wouldest give me. And then what did you do? Then you used to praise me. You were kind to me and wouldest give me water with berries in it. So water with berries in it, it's like he's trying to tell that Prospero must have given him coffee to drink, right? So water with berries in it means coffee. So then you used to give me this drink with water, made of water and berries, and teach me how to name the bigger light. Bigger light is the sun. And how the less? The lesser light is the moon. So you told me the names. See, Caliban was living all by himself on that island when Prospero came. So he didn't know how to speak anything. He was completely oblivious of language. And what do you call the bigger light and the smaller light? What do you call the sun is known as the sun and the moon is known as the moon? He was completely unaware of these things. He didn't know anything about language. But when Prospero came to this island, he pitied Caliban. He was kind towards Caliban and he gave him coffee to drink and he taught him about the sun and about the moon. Means what is this bigger light called and what is this smaller light called? That burn by day and night. So the bigger light burns by day, that is the sun, and the lesser light burns by night, that is the moon. And then I loved thee. And that was the time when I was also very fond of you. I loved you at that time. And showed thee all the qualities of the eye. And then, because I also started liking you at that time. I was also fond of you at that time. So what did I do? I showed you the qualities of the eye. Qualities of the eye means all the good and the bad parts of this island. The fertile lands, the fresh waters, the barren lands, and the salt water places, all these things I showed you. The fresh springs, the brine pits means the areas with salty water. Fresh springs means from where you get the fresh water, barren places and fertile. So these were shown by me to you. Cursed be I that did so. So Caliban says that now I am cursing myself that I did all this, that I made you acquainted with all the these qualities of the island that I told you about every nook and corner of this island. I am cursing myself for this now at this present moment. All the charms of Psychorax towards beetles, bats, lichen. So then he again starts cursing. That now I wish that all the charms, means all the witchcraft, all the magic spells of my mother Psychorax, whether it is towards beetles, bats, light, all these may fall upon you, right? So this is again the curse uttered by Caliban for Prospero. For I am all the subjects that you have. So I am your only subject. See, nobody else lives on that island. So this is what Caliban says, that I am your only subject on this island. You don't have anyone else to rule upon. He has only Miranda and Caliban, which first was mine own king. So earlier I was the king of this island, and now because of you, I have become your subject, right? Now I am your slave. I have to listen to what you say. Earlier, my position was of the king of this island, and here you stymie. And now you have started treating me like a pig. Stymie means you have started keeping me like a pig in this hard rock. So now I am only confined to this hard rock. I am not free to move throughout the island, whilst you do keep from me the rest of the island. And the rest of the island is in your control. This rock is the only place which has been assigned to me. I cannot move out from this rock, right? Even if I feel like the most lying slave, whom stripes may move, not kindness. So Prospero says, you are a lying creature. You are the most lying slave. You cannot speak the truth. You can be moved only by stripes. Stripes means here whip, right? You can only be moved. You can only be made to do work by whipping, because you don't understand the language of kindness. So only whipping can move you. Only whipping can force you to do the work, because you don't understand this language of kindness. I have used thee, filth as thou art. Though you are a piece of filth, piece of dirt, good for nothing, still, what did I do? I have used thee, filth as thou art, with human care. What did I do? I tried to treat you with human care. I tried to show humanity towards you. Though you are no better than filth, than dirt, abhorred slave. You are the most detestable slave, right? You are someone who is very hateful, who can only be hated. But I still tried to be kind to you. I still showed my kindness, my generosity, my humanity to you. Abhorred slave, which any print of goodness will not be. Because you are a detestable creature, because you are a piece of filth, because you are the son of witch, so it is quite obvious that any print of goodness, any amount of goodness, you will not take. You will not imbibe any good qualities from others. You will not take any goodness from others. You cannot have human values. Being capable of all ill, because you are only capable of all ill, all evil, all wickedness. So you did not take any good things from me. I tried to teach you. I tried to make you into a civilized being, but still, I failed in all my attempts. And why did I fail? Because you were not willing to absorb any good things which were taught to you. Why? Because you were only capable of ill and evil things. I pitied. I pitied thee, means because I was a human being. So I pitied you. I was kind towards you. I showed pity towards you, kindness towards you. Took pains to make thee speak. And because I pitied you, so I took pains. I made a lot of effort to teach you how to speak. Taught thee each hour, one thing or the other. And every hour that I came to this island, in the beginning, I tried to teach you. Every hour of my life, how did I spend on this island? Trying to teach you something or the other. because you were like a savage, you were completely uncivilized. So I spent most of my time trying to teach you one or the other thing. When thou didst not savage, know thine own meaning. Your condition was such that you didn't know your own meaning. Whatever you uttered, you didn't understand your own sound. You didn't understand your own language. You were just going on blabbering nonsense like animals. Meaningless sounds you made. But I, after coming on this island, I took all the pains. I made all the efforts to teach you how to speak. But what does gabble like? A thing most brutish. Thing most brutish means you used to talk like animals. Meaningless sounds were made by you. So that is the meaning of this line, that know thine own meaning. You didn't even understand your own meaning. Forget about us understanding what you were speaking. So because your language was like that of a brute, it was very brutish. It was like animals, the sounds made by animals. I endowed thy purposes with words that made them know. So what did I do? I gave meaning to your language with words. So whatever you wanted to say, whatever was your purpose of speaking, I gave you proper words by teaching you language that made them know. So in this manner, people started understanding you, right? It became easier for us to understand you, what you wanted, what you were trying to communicate. See, without language, it would be very difficult to understand the person. So that is what Prospero was saying, that I taught you language, and so your sounds, then after learning language, whatever you said became understandable for us. Before that, you were only making strange sounds like animals, which didn't make any sense, but thy wild brains. But again, in spite of making all this effort to make you a civilized being, in spite of putting in so much pain to teach you language, what did you do? But thy wild brains. Why? Because you belong to evil. You belong to the useless, wicked race. So thou, though thou didst learn, had that in it which good natures could not abide to be with. Though you learned how to speak, no doubt you learned our language. You learned how to talk in a proper manner. But because you were evil, so in you good nature cannot live. Goodness cannot reside in so much evil which is inside you. You are made up of evil. So that is why no good quality can abide to be with, means it cannot live with you. Therefore, wast thou deservedly confined into the world. So that is why, because in spite of all my efforts, which I made in the beginning, I failed to make any impact on you. My goodness failed to make any impact or any impression on you, because you were made of only wickedness and evil. So that is why you only deserved to be confined in this rock. And so you were rightfully confined in this rock by me, because this is what you deserve. Being evil, you didn't deserve to look, you didn't deserve to live like normal human beings. So that is why you were confined into this rock, deservedly confined in this rock. So you deserved to be kept in this rock. This is what you actually are for. Your deeds, the hateful things which you do, you are rightfully kept inside this rock. Who had us deserved more than a prison? Though and still, I am kind enough to keep you in this rock. You deserved to live in a prison. The type of creature you are, you deserve nothing less than a prison. But see my kindness, I am still kind and generous to you by keeping you in this rock instead of throwing you inside the prison behind bars. Caliban, you taught me language and my profit on it is I know how to curse. So Caliban is kind of mocking at Prospero and he says, see, you taught me language and see how I use the language which you taught me. I started cursing you people. The red plague rid you for learning me your language. May red plague fall upon you. Red plague is the disease, right? Plague is the disease which is spread by rats. So may red plague fall upon you. They have written leprosy, right? So may this disease fall upon you for learning me your language. What learning me your language means? For teaching me your language. So this is what he is doing with language. Right? It depends, no matter how much you teach a person, how much you try to make a person a good human being. But if the inherent qualities of the person are bad, if the person has only evil inside him, he will make those good things also. He will put these good things taught to him to some wicked use. This is what Caliban has been doing. Right? Prospero taught him language. He started cursing. Earlier he was not able to curse. Now he can curse in meaningful words. Earlier he used to make only strange sounds. But now he learned language, so he started cursing. This shows how wicked he was. So he again curses Prospero. The red plague rid you for learning me your language. For teaching me your language, may red plague fall upon you. Right? May you be inflicted by red plague. Prospero, hag seed, hence. So this annoys Prospero. Prospero says, you son of a hag, you son of a witch. Hag seed means you son of a witch. Hence, fetch us in fuel. So just go away quickly and bring fuel for us. Bring wood for us. And be quick. And don't waste time. Go immediately and fetch wood for us. Thou art best to answer other business. Why? It is in your best interest to go and fetch the wood quickly because you have other jobs to perform. Right? There is other work waiting for you. Other tasks are still in waiting for you. So you better hurry up and go fetch wood for us. Shuggest thou malice? And are you unwilling? You are reluctant to do. Shuggest thou means reluctance. Don't try to show me your reluctance. Are you reluctant to do? You malicious creature, you ill-natured thing, disgusting thing, you are trying to show your unwillingness, your reluctance to me. If thou neglectest, then he won't. If thou neglectest or dost unwillingly. So you dare neglect my instructions, or you dare show your unwillingness to what I command, to my instructions, to my commands. Don't you dare show your negligence. I'll drag thee. What will happen if you do it? I'll drag thee with old cramps. Then the cramps which you have been given in the past, the previous cramps with which you suffered from for disobedience, don't forget that. I will again inflict you with those cramps and pains. Fill all thy bones with aches, and then your entire body will be filled with aches and pains. Make thee roar, and you will cry, roar in pain, that beasts shall tremble at thy din. And even your cries will be so horrible, so painful, so terrible, that even the beasts and the animals of this island, they will start shivering at thy din. At thy din means at the noise which you will produce, at your groans, those painful cries which you will make. Even the animals of this island, they will start trembling and shivering. Caliban, no, Prairie. Now Caliban is scared. On listening to this, he is scared. He says, no, I pray thee, I request you, please don't do this. I beg of you, please leave me, don't do this. Aside. And then these are the things which Caliban speaks to himself. Right? Whenever this word comes aside, it means the character is not talking to any other character. Or whatever he's saying after this word in brackets, he is, that these things are not heard by the other characters. Right? So Caliban moves to one side and he says, I must obey. So Caliban, this is what Caliban is talking to himself. He says, I need to obey what he's saying. His art is of such power, it would control my damn Scots city boys and make a vassal of him. So he says, no, no, I will have to obey what he is saying, because if I anyhow try to disobey him, right, disregard his instructions, what will happen? I know, because Caliban is aware of this fact that Prospero is a very powerful magician. He has experienced Prospero's power in the past, the way Prospero must have punished him in the past, right? So that is why he's scared now. And he says, first he curses, then when Prospero warns him, he's scared and he says, I beg you, please leave me, please don't do this to me, right? And then he moves to one side and he says, I don't have any option but to obey him. Because if I disregard his instructions, what will happen? His art is of such power. His magic powers his magic art is very powerful. It would control my damn Scott City Pose. What will it do? It is so powerful. Damn Scott means my mother's God, City Pose. I told you. Right? Even the God to whom my mother prayed. Right? The God who taught my mother witchcraft and all these magic charms. Prospero is even able to control him. Even Seti Bose will be scared of Prospero's magic. Right? So he can even control Seti Bose, who was my mother's god, and make a vassal of him. And make a vassal of him means he can even make Seti Bose his servant. Forget about me. So that is why it would be in my best interest that I obey his command. I cannot afford to ignore his instructions. So then Prospero calls out, so slave, hence. So he says, now slave, quickly go away from here and do your job. Exit Caliban. And then Caliban leaves the place. Re-enter Ariel, invisible, playing and singing. When Caliban leaves, then Ariel re-enters the scene. Now Ariel is at a different place because it's written Ferdinand following. So Ariel is, I told you, we know this, that Ariel is invisible to everyone except Prospero and himself, right? So Ariel goes to the place where Ferdinand was sitting, right? What was Ferdinand doing? You remember when Ariel told him, when Ariel narrated to Prospero the details of the shipwreck, he said that I have left all the passengers in groups in this island. They are in their troops on this island. And each one thinking the other to be dead. Means groups of 4 or 5 people, they have been scattered in different parts of the island. And they are roaming here and there. There is only one person who is alone all by himself. And who is that person? Ferdinand. Right? Ferdinand was left alone. I told you the reason also why Ferdinand was left alone. Because he was supposed to fall in love with Miranda. This is what Prospero has planned for him. Right? So Ferdinand, Ariel goes to the place where Ferdinand was sitting. And then, because Ariel is invisible, so Ferdinand is not able to see Ariel. And then Ariel starts playing and singing. Means the music is played and he starts singing. So Ferdinand is only able to hear the sound of the music and the song played by Ariel. He is actually not able to see Ariel. So now this is the song, which we'll do it on the next turn. We'll stop here and continue on the next turn.